welcome to Indie Chats. I'm Nicole Delger of NicoleDelger.com. We are here in the Portraits to the People studio in San Francisco. I'm joined by Catherine Nelson of Nelson Daily. And thank you so much for joining us.
Well, thank you for having me here.
You do kind of public relations, content creation for your clients. Mm-hmm. What is it really important for independent brands to know when it comes to telling their story?
Well, I think my background is as a journalist, so I come back to telling a story from a journalist perspective as well as a brand perspective. And I think that just can't be overstated how important it is to really, really hone that story and to get it so that you know it yourself, you know it in your heart, your PR person, whoever you're working with, consulting with, can articulate it, and that you're able to articulate it in conversations with media. And I think you get there by just, at least my methodology is asking yourself some really dumb questions, like, why am I doing this, and why is it important, and, you know, why is it interesting, why should other people care? Because journalists are going to ask you those questions. Why are you doing this? Why is it interesting? Why would my readers care about it? Mm-hmm. So I think that you can think of it also from their perspective. They will be asking you those questions too. So it's good to have the answers beforehand. I mean, you can do it at the time, but probably better to have them, you know, up your sleeve.
And sometimes, you know, I'll be working with different clients or working with different people, and they'll say, you know, oh, I'd love to get press. And I always want to say, well, do something interesting.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, journalists, they're always looking for a hook. They're always looking for an angle. They want to write about something that their competitors aren't writing about. I mean, that's how they're going to get readers. That's how people are going to come to their blog or magazine or whatever, as opposed to some other place. So that's why they're really interested in that story and, you know, what is interesting. And I don't think it's that, you know, you have to do something weird or wild. I think they're just genuinely curious about, you know, what's exciting, why are you passionate, why are you getting up in the morning and doing this, you know, I mean, that's interesting to them as well.
Yeah. And so, you know, for independent brands, I think that moment when you bring on a communications partner or a publicist or whatever the case may be, it's a really huge hiring decision.
Yes.
It's a big investment. So if I'm looking to work with somebody in that field, what are the kinds of things I should look for in a partner?
Well, I think it's the same thing that we also look for in our clients. It's just kind of an understanding that you get them, they get you. It's really, really important that when you're talking to them, that when they talk back to you, when they're sort of coming back to you with your story, that you're like, yeah, that's right. And you have a kind of synergy is really important, because basically what's gonna happen is that those people are gonna be let loose on the world, and they're gonna be talking and you're not gonna be there. They're gonna be pitching you, and they're gonna be at a conference or running into a colleague, and they're gonna be telling your story to them, and you may not be there. I mean, most of the time in press previews, it's really great to have the indie brand, the owner there, and obviously the best story is hearing it from your own words. But a lot of business and a lot of media happens just through those relationships, so you've got to feel really confident that person gets you and comfortable with them, you know, out in the world talking about you.
Yeah, and I think we were talking before too is also having a partner that is out in the world.
Yes.
And does kind of have those relationships. It's really important.
Absolutely. I work in a very specialized field. I do PR for creative companies, designers, interior designers, architects. That was the field I covered as a journalist for the New York Times and other publications. And you know, having those relationships does really help, and knowing an industry does really help as well.
Yeah, I love what you said there too, is, you know, they might say from a cold call you have 3 seconds, but if you know them, you have eight.
Yeah, exactly. You know, yeah. It makes a difference.
Yeah, absolutely, it does. To that point, you've gone out there, no matter how you've secured this opportunity to have a conversation with a journalist, you know, what do you think is important when you're on that phone and this is your moment to kind of talk about your business?
Well, I think it's really, really important to have that story down pat. You know, I think that's very important. and to have it refined. But in addition to that, I think that it's important to know that you also can direct the conversation in not kind of a skeevy way, in a way where you know, the journalist is talking to you because they want the information, they want the hook, they want what's newsworthy. So whatever you're passionate about, I mean, the reason you're getting up in the morning is to do this business where your passion is, that's the hook, that's the story. So you're not being strange to kind of direct them to that in the conversation. Mm-hmm. At the end of a conversation, any good journalist will say, is there something that I, you know, should have asked you that I didn't? And then that's your point. You can jump in, well, actually, you know, this was kind of really important. Mm-hmm. You know, I want to make sure that you know this about me or my business. Or you can even do that to begin with of the conversation. You can say, you know, before we get started, I just really want you to know this is kind of, you know, important. It is why I do what I do. So you don't have to sort of be on the receiving ends of lots of, you know, pointed questions. You can work with them and bring their ways to naturally bring your story into theirs.
And I love what you said when we talked prior to about curiosity.
Yes, yeah. I mean, journalists are naturally curious people. They're not out to get you. Journalists are people too. They wouldn't be doing what they're doing otherwise. And so they really just want to hear from you. They wouldn't be calling you up and wasting their time if they didn't want to hear your story. So now's your chance, you know. You can tell them what makes you tick. I mean, they are all ears. They want to get the scoop. One thing that's important to keep in mind, though, is that they are on deadline, and mm-hmm. there's not a lot of chances to go back and back and back to them. You do want to be clear enough in your own mind, have worked out those things ahead of time, that when you are, you know, ready to talk to them, you're able to get to those points. But you're in a conversation. You're going back and forth. You can direct. You can say, oh, you know, I didn't emphasize that correctly, or, you know what I really meant to say is this. It's, you know, it's just a talk. On the most part, journalists who cover those kinds of fields are very interested in the nature of creativity, and that's why that they're talking to you. They want to hear about your creative instincts and impulses.
Yeah, and we talked earlier too, is I think what's great is, you know, telling that story and also really knowing the industry that you're in so that you can see trends and be able to anyways, I'd love for you to talk about that.
Well, we've kind of talked about the idea of trends and how that helps sort of center articulate why it is that you do what you do. I mean, trends kind of get a bad rap in the sense that, you know, no one wants to be trendy. But on the other hand, you can look at it from this perspective where we're all out there in the world and there are certain things that are happening that we're all a part of. And in my industry, for example, locally made products are really interesting mm-hmm. to people. Things that are made by hand. People who are manufacturing things with lost techniques because we're losing so many manufacturing jobs abroad. These are not new ideas. If you happen to be working in this, there are probably a lot of other people that are doing this too. You're kind of part of a movement. You're part of a trend or a theme in our culture. And sort of being able to place yourself in that makes your story relevant. But on the other hand, you want to be turning it on its ear just a bit, making it kind of fresh, doing something a little or a lot different than all these other people are doing. So in a way, being able to articulate to a journalist or writer, you know, what the bigger issue is that you're addressing that's important to the culture and community, and then how it is that you in particular are making something special, how you are someone that they should write about as opposed to all these other people out there. So it's kind of being able to balance both of those sides of the coin in, you know, articulating your brand story.
And I think I love your journalism background. I think that's such a great insight, and I really appreciate your time sharing.
Oh, thank you so much for inviting me.
And so for those who are watching that might be interested, how can they learn more about working with you?
Well, the company is Nelson Daily. Our website is nelsondaily.com, and I have a partner in Los Angeles, Mira Daily, and I'm obviously the Nelson, Catherine Nelson. We're writers, which makes us a little bit different from other PR agencies in the sense that my background is as a journalist for the New York Times, LA Times. I wrote a book for Chronicle Books. I worked as an editor in New York for many years. So I think what Mira and I can bring to it as writers is our slogan is, we tell your story. And I think that we really get to the heart of a lot of creative businesses and are able to do content, to write things for you, do websites, social media programs, as well as to pitch media. Because I'm a journalist at heart, it comes very naturally for me. So we focus on a lot of creative businesses, designers, interior designers, fabric designers, product designers, and lifestyle companies. And we're here to tell your story.
I could probably talk about pitching and press and brands all day long.
Yeah,
so
if you have comments
on your own, please join us on NicoleDelger.com. Leave a comment under the blog and the video. We'd love to hear your stories or your advice. And thank you so much to Sarah Darragon of Portraits of the People for having us in her beautiful studio here in San Francisco. And while you're on my website, get on my newsletter. I would love to be able to hop into your inbox. So with that shameless plug, thanks so much, guys.
Thanks, Nicole.
Until next time.
Thanks for watching. I'm Catherine Nelson. I am founder with Mira Daily, Nelson Daily. We're a content creation and media consulting firm.
What's your favorite sound?
My favorite sound?
Hold on one second.
You know what? I have these kids and they're just so noisy. I don't even register.
Like, how old are your kids?
2 and 4. You know, I'm just like screaming, things breaking. I don't even, an ambulance could come by, I wouldn't even know.
Like,
so it's like.